Everybody concentrate here. You can copy down the network. Okay. Here there are multiple stars, multiple deltas. Okay. So we need to bring it down to one delta somehow. Everybody understand that? So see, 2, 2, 2 is a delta. This external 2, 2, 2 is again a delta. Whereas 4, 2, 2 is a star. 2, 4, 2, 2, 4, 2. These are all stars. Okay. Do anything you want, but at the end, get me one delta out of it. Fine. So that is what we are trying to do now. Now, how to approach that? Fine. In the solution, what we shall do is, see here, everybody, you have this 2, 2, 2 delta, right? Okay. Let's convert that into star. And after you convert that into star, that should look like this. That means this 2, 2, 2 and vanish. And what will come? Okay. For example, let me call this as RA. In stars, you'll be having RA, RB, RC, right? So you have RA, RB, and RC. Okay. And since all the resistors in the delta are same, okay, your RA, RB, RC would also be same. Is that understood, everybody? So how to find out RA, RB, RC is the question. Fine. So in the solution, what can we have? Let me take the solution here. Since we are converting a delta into star, we are obtaining RA. What is RA? See here, RA is here. On both sides of RA, you have 2 and 2 ohms. So it would be 2 into 2, 2 into 2 divided by 2 plus 2 plus 2. Okay. So it would be 4 by 6. What is 4 by 6? It is 0.67 ohms, we can say. Since all the resistors are same, we can say RA, RB, and RC are 0.67 ohms. So what we have found out is in red, what I have marked here. Okay, that is the star I have obtained now. So after you have obtained your star out of this delta, the circuit or the network looks like what? Therefore, the network becomes, what does that become? See here, you have to write the whole stuff again. What is it? You write it a little bigger. Everybody copy this. So this is the outermost what? Delta you have, 2 ohms, 2 ohms, 2 ohms. Fine. Then after that you have, let me mark this. This is A. That's fine. Let us bring in these 4, 4, and another 4 here. Okay. So they're all 4 ohms. They're all 4 ohms. See, now RA is connected with the upper 4 and RC, RB, all are connected to these 4 ohms. So what we can do is we can bring in these resistors here. This is something that I have just obtained. Is this okay with you? So what we have got after obtaining, we have got this as 0.67. Okay, 0.67. And this also is 0.67. Okay. your A is here and B is here. This is how the things look like after you convert. Everybody's okay with that? Now, let's move forward. Now, from here on, what is visible here? Are there any resistors in series? Yes. See here, this 4 and 0.61, and in all these branches, you have got two resistors in series. Understand that? So, how to do that? Therefore, in the next step, the circuit implies this. Okay, this is outer 222 delta. Okay, then you have this. Understand that? So what is it? It is 4.67 and 4.67 after combining the resistors in series. So this is something that we had seen earlier in one of the problems. We had seen this, if you remember the last class, we took this problem, right? So it has reduced to this problem now. Fine. We found out the resistance across AB, right? So this is what the problem is now after you have come to this particular step. Okay. I'll just give you the answer from here on. Fine. What you're doing, you're just converting the star into delta. Okay. And the new delta will have the branches in parallel to this. Okay. And fine. AB. I'm giving you the answer. Okay. That answer is 1.16 ohms. Fine. So from here on, you work. Okay. To get your RAB equal to 1.16 ohms. Because it's the same problem that we had done yesterday. Okay, so this is what we had to learn here. So how to approach this? Okay, so we have approached this problem by converting the innermost delta into star. Okay, then we can have the branches of this star, okay, in series with the 4 ohms which was existing earlier in the given problem. Okay, and that is how we have reduced into this, and from here on you will convert the star into delta, and we'll see that the resistance between the terminals AB would happen to be 1.16. okay, from here on you should not have any problems getting this. Now let's move on to another problem. Okay, that is this. This is problem number 4. Yeah. This is problem number 4. What we are doing here? We are finding out, find the equivalent resistance between the terminals XY. Using star delta conversion. Using star delta conversions. Everybody's okay with that? Now, you should understand here, there are multiple ways of solving this particular problem. Okay? I've got my own way of solving this. Okay? But it need not be the same solution. Every individual can have his own or her own solution to this. Okay, it all depends on how you visualize whether you are approaching a delta or you are approaching a star. Okay, if you are approaching a delta, which delta, or if you are approaching a star, which star you would approach. Okay, so depending on that, the solutions would differ. Get that? Whatever you do, at the end, the answer should be same. Okay? So RXY should be same. Fine. I'll give you my method, my approach. You can think of other approaches and try to get the same answer after we solve this. Okay? So I hope you're copying this. Copy this fast. Fine. So what is that we are supposed to be doing now? We are supposed to be, see here, this is there, right? So we need to somehow cut this loose from this knot. There is a knot here, okay? So there is no connection here, okay? So you need to be a little careful when you're dealing with this. Fine. The rest of the things, if you can just cut loose that, okay, the things fall in place and you can easily deal with the problem. I'll tell you how I'm doing this. If you have your own method, I'm happy. Okay. Now, in the solution, everybody, just copy down what I'm doing here. I'll try to write the same circuit in other way. Okay, so let's say rewrite the given network as following. Rewrite the given network as following. So how we are going to write that? Everybody just observe here. Let me draw that here and I'll take it there later on. Fine. Now see everybody. 15 ohm is there. This 45 is there. Let's keep them as it is. Okay, there is a 45 ohms and there is a 25 ohms. So I've kept all these the same. I'm not manipulating them. X, Y. Okay. So 15, 45, 25. This 40. So this part I have not done anything. 15, 45, 25, 40. This I have not done anything. So I'll be trying to rearrange this 20 ohms, 35 ohms, and 30 ohms. So these three resistors I'll be rearranging. Okay. Now see, these three resistors together would form a star actually. 20 ohms, 35 ohms, and 30 ohms there, right? So at this point, they have come together. So these three resistors, okay, together will form a star. So we need to adjust that in such a way that you would see a star there. So I rather do it like this. Let me just drag this. Yeah. Fine. Let's have this. Fine. Then I do this. Okay. And then yeah, this is what my visualization of the circuit is. If you have to take that star out of the jumble. Fine. Can you make out these resistors now? Which resistor is this? Which resistor is this? These resistors you have to make out. These resistors you have to make out. Fine. See, if you just observe this, this 20 ohms is coming from this point on. So this is the same resistor. This is where the resistor. So this is 20 ohms. From here, which resistor is moving out? Yeah. In this 35 ohms. So this is 35 ohms. Okay. And anyways, this is 30 ohms. The one which is coming out of this point is 30 ohms. So that is how we have got our, see here, 30 ohms, then 20 ohms, then 35 ohms. I hope everybody is clear with what we have just done. Is this okay with you, everybody? We have still not solved the problem. We have just tried to look at a star, okay, in the way we want. Right. So the circuit now looks like this. Just a minute, it's taking time. Yeah. So this is how the things are. Okay. Now that star which we have taken out, this 30, 20 and 35. Let us convert them into a delta. Okay. So how can I do that? So this is one branch. This is another branch, and this is the last branch of the delta. You're understanding what I'm doing? So we have selected or identified a star, and that star is being converted into a delta. So I'm obtaining a delta means what is that? I'm obtaining R1, R2, and R3. You need to be really, really careful when it comes to finding out these resistors when you have different resistors here. Okay, R1, R2, R3 would be different. So R1, after finding out R1, that R1 needs to be connected at this place only. Sometimes people interchange and tend to get the other answer, which should not be the case. Okay, so converting this star into a delta, we have obtained R1, R2, R3. Everybody look at this. I'll give you how to calculate R1. You can give me what? R2, R3. See here, R1 is here, right? In the numerator of R1, R2, R3, what would be there in the numerator? You'd be having RA, RB, RB plus RB, RC plus RC, RA, right? So some of the product of resistor pairs. So that we shall have first. This is common, fine. So that is 20 into 35 plus 35 into 30 plus 30 into what? 20. In the denominator, what will you have? In the denominator, what will you have is the question. What is that you're going to have in the denominator? See here, which is there perpendicular to this? Which branch is there perpendicular to this? Okay, so that should be taken. So 35 ohms is there, okay, with this. If you see opposite to this, it is 20. Okay, if you see opposite to this, it is 30. If you see opposite to this, it is 35. So 35 would come in the denominator. So we have R1 equal to, in the numerator, just calculate the numerator once. Okay, 2350 is what numerator would be. Okay, and that would be common in all the three resistors, and 35 here. So this is, you can just copy it down, 67.14 ohms. Similarly, if you go to R2, this 2350 would be same, because this is same for all the three resistors when we are converting a star into delta. What will you have in the new denominator here for R2? See, R2 is here. If you see opposite like this, okay, so you have 30 ohms. Okay, so it is divided by 30 ohms, and that happens to be 78.33 ohms. Fine. Similarly, your R3 numerator is same, and in the denominator you will have 20. Okay, and that gives you 117.5 ohms. Now there is a challenge. You have to observe it very, very, very carefully. See here, just for your for the sake of understanding, let me do this. Okay, you don't do this, just observe. Suppose I mark this as A. Okay, I mark this as A. Then this as B and this as C. Fine. So if this is A means, if this is A, means this also is A. Fine. If this is B means, this also is B. If this is C, this also is C. Is everybody okay with this? Yes? Now, see here, between A and B, you have 45. Between A and B, what do you have here? Between A and B, what is there? Where is that? Yeah, between A and B, you have 30 ohms. Between A and B, you have R1, that is 67.14. R1 is there between A and B. Okay, that means this, there is between A and B, you also have 45. That means R1 would come in parallel with 45 ohms. Similarly, R2 is between A and C, right? So between A and C, you have 25 ohms. So this R2 would come in parallel with 25 ohms. Similarly, this R3 would come in parallel with this 40 ohms. So that needs to be written down. Is that okay with you, everybody? So therefore, you can just mark this and you can do that. Okay, so this will be a good exercise. A is there. Okay, B is there. C is there. So there are 2 points now. A, B. And this is also AB. So that means between AB, you have two resistors, 20 and R1. Okay. And that would be in parallel. Write that now. So further, it implies that you have 15 ohms, 45. Then this is 20, 40. Okay. 15, 45, 40, then 25. Okay. Just mark this. This is XY is what we need to find the resistance across. Okay, but let's mark this ABC also. ABC. Between A and B, we will be having one more resistor. Okay, between A and C, we'll be having another resistor. Okay, and between B and C, you will have another resistor. Is this okay with you, everybody? This is how the things fall in place. Now, see here, between A and B, you have 45. Between A and B, you also have R1. So R1 is 67.14. So 67.14 would come here. 67.14. In parallel with 25, what would be there? In parallel with 25, between AC, R2 is there. So R2 is 78.33 ohms. And the remaining one is 117.5 ohms. Now see, all these pairs are in parallel. So after you combine them, after you take the equivalent resistances of the parallel combinations, okay, you would tend to get this. So this is how the circuit would reduce. XY is there, okay? This is 50 ohms, 15 ohms, which we have not done, which we have not manipulated. Okay, after you take those series parallel combinations, okay? So this is 25 parallel, 78.33, which would be 18.95. Just copy it down. You can calculate it later on. Okay. Similarly, this is 14 parallel with 117.5. Okay. This would be 29.84. And this is 67.14 in parallel with 45 ohms. Okay. And this happens to be 26.94. Is that okay with you? Now, there are two resistors now. Okay, see, these two resistors are in series. This and this. Yes or no? So that needs to be combined now. So these two are in series. So this series combination would be in parallel with this. Understand? So this would reduce to 15, this is 26.94. Okay, and after you get these two resistors in series, so that would be the series combination is what you see. This is 18 plus 95, okay, in series with 29.84. Get that point? So XY is here. XY is here. Now these two are in parallel, and that parallel combination is in series with 15. So therefore, what I can say from here on is, therefore, our RXY is actually, this 15 ohms is there, right? So this 15 ohms in series with parallel combination of 26.94 and what is this 18.94? Just see that it's 18.95 plus 29.85. I don't have that value with you. You can do it fast that you can see. So this is how things go. Okay, and you'll find your RXY to be 32.35. Fine, this is how the things go. Okay, so now we have another problem. Fine, I'll give that to you. Okay, now. We're left with 10 minutes. I hope I'll be able to give you what I am planning to. Yeah, this is the third problem that we are looking at. Sorry, this is not third problem. What is the problem number? The sixth one or the fifth one? Okay. And this is fourth, and we have this as the fifth problem. What they're asking us, to find out the equivalent resistance between the terminals AB. Okay. Now, I'll just give you the thought process, how you should be getting it. Now see here, you have these three registers. You have stars 3, 5, 4, 3 would give you a star. This 5, 4, 3 would give you a star. 6, 8, 4 would give you a star. Understand that? And there is this 10 ohms, which is not part of these two stars. Fine. So what you will do is this. See, yeah? You will catch hold of any one star. So that means, let me tell you, you just take this star. 6, 4, 8 is there, right? Take that star. Okay. And convert that into a delta. Like this. Everybody get that point? You have to convert that into delta. Now, after you convert that into delta, how did things fall in place? Is what I'll be giving you. Just everybody observe. Just you can just copy it down fast. Okay. What I'm giving you is the approach. So after you take that star into delta, okay, this 5, 4 and 3, this 10 ohms. So we are not manipulating this. So they are the same. This is A, B, 5 ohms is as it is, 4 ohms is as it is, 3 and 10 are also as it is. Now, see here, you see this point, you see this point. So these two points are the same and these two points are the same. So that means you will have this resistor. Let me name this. That means we are obtaining a delta, right? So let me call this delta as R1, R2 and R3. Everybody okay with this? R1, R2, R3 is the delta we are having. Fine. Now, where would that R1, R2, R3 would come? Okay. See, this is where your R1 is coming. This is where your R1 comes. Fine. Here is R3. Where is R3 coming? So R3 is coming between, this is A. So this is A and this is B. So between A and B, R3 should come. See here? Between A and B, R3 should come. Where is R2 coming? R2 is coming between these two points. That means across 18, across 10. This is not 8, this is 10. Let me write that properly. This is 10. Okay, so across 10 ohms, you will have your R2. This is how the things are. Okay, R1, R2, R3, I'm not found out. I'll leave it for you. Okay, now. From here on, what you can do? From here on, what we can do? See, there is a delta out here. This R153 is there, right? R1 and 5 and 3. So that's a delta. Okay. So that delta now be converted into a star. This delta, I mean. Okay, where is it? Yeah. See, this is R1, 5 and 3 is there, right? So that needs to be converted into a star. So that means what you can do, you can simply bring this. Okay. So this is how the star would look like. And you can call it as RA, RB and RC. So where will your RA, RB, RC come? Okay, is the question. Fine. Where would your RA come? Your RA, see, is between this point and RC. Okay. So if you do that, how the circuit is going to look like is what we need to be thinking. Fine. So you can try this problem yourself, because if you start doing it yourself, then you will see that if you just get to calculate this and properly bring them in the net given network, you will not have this 5-3 and R1. You will not have this 5-3 and R1. You will just be having RA, RB and RC. Let me give you that. Why? The R3 is there, right? Let this R3 be there. Okay. This is R3. Is there as it is. Then this is RA. This is RB. Okay. And this is RC. Then you have another 4 ohms. Then you have this 10. Then you have this R2. This is how the things go. Fine. Let me write. This is your RA, RB, RC in series with 4 ohms. Fine. This 10 and R2 are in parallel. So just combine these two. You'll have one resistor. Combine these two series combinations, you'll have one resistor. Is it okay with you? Okay. After doing that, you see that you should get your RAB. Should get your RAB as 4.933 ohms. So do this yourself. You'll have a good look at how the things go. Fine. Now, if you have not given your attendance, give your attendance fast. Okay. If you have anything to discuss, I think we can discuss that